In the video today, we're answering a viewer question because Michael A. asks us, does testosterone cause more body hair? Just before we get started, we'd like to send a shout out to a longtime writer and paramedic here at Today I Found Out. That is Scott, who, besides being the author of the script for this video, he also happens to co-host a hilarious podcast called Medical Confessions, which I thoroughly recommend you check out. If you like in-depth coverage of various medical topics done in a humorous way, that podcast is absolutely for you. There is a link below this video. Please go check it out. And yeah, let's get on with today's video. Testosterone is a steroid hormone from a group called androgens. Androgens affect a lot of different characteristics in our bodies, like the development of the male sex organs, the deepening of the voice during puberty, muscle and bone strength, as well as hair growth. Interestingly, the same circulating androgen, like testosterone, can increase hair growth in one area of our bodies and inhibit it in others. Thought to be gene-dependent, these differences affect our appearance in several ways. Before we tackle why, it's important to understand how testosterone is produced and how hair grows. Testosterone is produced by specialized cells called Leydig cells in the male testes and in the female ovaries. They do this by receiving signals from your anterior pituitary gland. The pituitary senses the need for more testosterone and signals the Leydig cells with a hormone known as luteinizing hormone. Cholesterol is used to make steroid hormones known as progesterone and progesterone. These are then transformed into testosterone. The luteinizing hormone, coming from your pituitary gland, increases the rate at which this happens. Once testosterone is made, it begins to circulate around the body looking for receptor sites to attach to. Known as androgen receptors, in the case of hair, they reside in an area of your hair follicle called your dermal papilla. Once there, the testosterone androgen binds to androgen receptors and initiates any altered gene expression. This will either help the follicle or it will hurt it, depending on the gene expressed. Hair, like other cells in our bodies, have a growth cycle. There are three phases. Anagen, this is the active growth stage. 80 to 85% of hair is in this phase. Catagen, this phase is also known as the transitional phase, when hair begins to stop growing. And telogen, this is the phase when hair growth is completely shut down and the fibers fall out. 10 to 15% of our hair is in this phase at any given time. After your hair goes through the telogen phase, anagen begins again and voila, more hair. The cycle then repeats itself throughout our lifetimes. Testosterone regulates hair growth by affecting the follicle and how it can produce the different types of hair, like facial, pubic, and scalp hair. These follicle changes affect the growth phases of hair, producing different reactions. The result is changes in hair growth, or lack thereof, occurring over time, as the growth cycle of hair can take as long as 7 years to complete. What has baffled researchers for decades is how a hormone like androgen can cause some hair's growth to be inhibited in one area of the body while helping it to grow in others. This paradox appears to be gene-related. There are two types of hair follicles within our bodies, villus and terminal. Villus hair follicles are the ones that create fine, virtually colorless hair like the ones found on infants. They are usually tiny and don't reside very deep within the skin. Terminal hair follicles are created from villus hair follicles by androgen. They are deeper and longer follicles that form thicker, longer, and more pigmented hair. To change from villus to terminal or from terminal to villus, the follicle must go through the hair growth cycle to regenerate as one type or another. Normally, during puberty, our bodies begin to produce more androgen. This circulating androgen then turns our young villus follicles into more terminal ones, and thus the boy becomes a man. As time goes on, certain terminal hair follicles, like the ones found on our scalp, can begin to regress back into villus follicles. This, too, is mediated by testosterone. The result is slowly dying hair follicles that don't grow back. What researchers have found is that individual hair follicles have different expressions of genes within the follicle. Each gene expression reacts differently to androgen. Some genes inhibit follicle health and some increase follicle health. Since each follicle is independent of one another, each gene expression is also independent of one another. This is why hair transplants work. The follicles on your head, they might be dying, but the ones in other areas of your body are not, so doctors can simply move them. The transplanted hair follicle will not die because the genes associated with that follicle are not negatively affected by androgen, no matter what area of the body they're in. The process that allows a specific gene to be expressed in a certain follicle is not yet fully understood. What is known is that the program programming occurs in the pattern processing during development. And now for some bonus facts. The higher the testosterone level is in vitro, the greater ability you will have to grow a beard. Now for another bonus fact. Certain bodybuilders and other athletes love to take testosterone supplements or other steroids to increase muscle mass. While this works quite effectively, excessive testosterone can cause several problems. They include heart muscle damage, acne, low sperm count, shrinking of the testicles, prostate enlargement, liver disease, high blood pressure, insomnia, and headaches. Low testosterone can also cause problems. In adulthood, this may decrease your sexual desire, cause erectile dysfunction, loss of hair, osteoporosis, and a decrease in your muscle mass. There are times, however, when this is not such a bad thing. In the case of prostate cancer, testosterone is thought to stimulate the prostate gland and cause the cancer to grow. As a result, if you have prostate cancer, doctors sometimes prescribe medications to reduce your testosterone level, like leuprolide. In some extreme cases, castration can also be performed, but in that case, maybe I'll just take the prostate cancer. Dark. So I really hope you found that video interesting. If you did, please do give us a thumbs up below, and don't forget to subscribe. Also, please do check out Medical Confessions, link below. And as always, thank you for watching.